So if you enjoy the video, leave a like, leave a follow, would mean a lot. You are here at the start of this channel. And yeah, here we see our TradingView account, which we created in another video. You can also see it on my channel. If you wanna start here with a free account on TradingView, you can check it up. I described everything. So today we're gonna check out like Bitcoin normally. You're gonna notice the Bitcoin chart like this, but we will look into it with a logarithmic. And we have three indicators right now. We have the RSI and two exponential moving averages, a 50 and a 200. So let's get into the chart. What do we see? I will use my own strategy to analyze this, and you of course can comment under the video if you want. If you have questions, just ask in the comments, and I can also make videos about like trend lines, about like supports and stuff like that. So the first thing we must notice here is the weekly chart. That's where I start because I like to start way out and zoom out and get everything clear and see everything. And yeah, first thing I want to do is set a 10k line here with you guys, so we can easily see, hey, we got to the 10k, and let's also see where we are at 10k before. And we were here at 10k, here, here, and here. As you can see, it's a fourth or third time, as you want, that we are at this price level. And as you can also see, we are today on a Monday, so a new candle just opened, and it's this one. It's not closed, it's not confirmed, it's far from it. You can see it here, 5 days until it closes. So we have no confirmation here on the weekly chart that the 10k level, the price level, is actually out, and we have it as a support. It's like the war zone at the moment. And next thing we want to do is like throwing out some lines, throwing on some correction lines, and see what we can see here. Got like correction lines from the atom high to the second high, and we can see here that we will likely touch in this week here you go, 11k is also a big resistance here. We can see it, and we can also mark it for ourselves that we have here a pretty important level at 11k. I will do this too with a line. I think it looks better at the end. As we watch the 11k level, we can also see that there are some interesting points, like this one here out of February 18, or this one right here almost a year ago. And 11k will be also pretty important, a big resistance. So we have a big resistance area, as you can see in the chart. I will mark it around 10k until 11k. So it's a pretty big resistance, of course. It's the range is also pretty big, but we are right now on the weekly chart. So the first thing we're gonna notice here is that the resistance is not broken. On the weekly chart, we are in an up run, of course. We got the 50 EMA line, of course, and we are still in the uptrend. We see that. Yeah, that's nice. But we have to keep in mind that this here is our big resistance we need to get over, and that would be pretty hard. We are not over on board here. That's good. RSI is like in the middle. You can also see that here in the RSI level on 60 is also pretty big resistance area. The last time we was here, like here on 10k, we couldn't get over it. So let's see if maybe this week we can do it. What do we also see from this like weekly chart here. It's from Coinbase. I hope it's okay. I started here with Coinbase. If you have any suggestions to go to some other exchanges, let me know. I can come here up with a lot of interesting stuff for you guys, I think, but keep in mind that English is not my first language. So for me, it's also like learning to speak in English. So that's a big value for me from these videos. And yeah, I hope you can stick with me through it. I know it's not perfect, but mean, that's the second video here on the channel. So come on. Yeah. You see that we're building here a nice bull flag, and that's something I think not everyone is seeing right now, but we can tell, yeah, since this one doesn't go under the 200 line and hold here and get another up, you could say that we are here in a nice bull flag, you know? And a bull flag normally breaks out to another high. So we have here, I will make it bigger for you guys. And let's keep in mind, that's just one possibility. That's every time you watch a chart, there are possibilities. Nothing is set in stone here. And the possibility rises if this chart goes over the 11K mark or the 10K mark or resistance area. Then this here becomes more likely. Right now it's just speculation, and right now if you wanna buy right now, you would buy in the resistance area with an unclosed, not confirmed 10K price level. And if it falls down right here to 6K again, what's possible, you would lose a lot, really a lot of money. And that's not what we want. It's like 40% down here, man, that's pretty deep. So for this chart, we are just looking into, yeah, the long distance, you know. We will get into the short distance pretty quick. Let's go to like the daily chart. I hope you like the music in the background. This is Stream Beats, free usable for Twitch and YouTube, as I know. And you can find it on Spotify. I will place it for you guys in the description, of course. So we are now on the daily chart. On the daily chart, you see as normally more candles, of course. So our lines from the weekly chart may be not perfectly drawn here. So maybe that's a good answer. What do you connect with the lines? Do you connect like the dots or the actual candles? And I always go with the most outranged line. So with the highest and the lowest points. That's the points where I take the lines, because I can use now the lines in like every possible time frame. Only here where we have a lot of volatility, I don't get the point down here, because we have three confirmations here and yeah, the big support here. So I take this line like that, just to show you guys like the possibility of a bull flag and the possibility of like in support down here if we come again in this area. Keep in mind also that the 200 line is pretty slow, so if the price should go fall down here, this line is not gonna do like that's not gonna happen. What this line is gonna do is like nothing. It's just going here like, yeah, who cares? The price falls here down, line doesn't care really much. You see it here. And so the green line, the trend line, and is also the 200 line if you want. It's pretty same, I would say. Let's go to the daily chart, what we also see here. We also see here a good thing, that we close the last daily candle over this one here at 9,000. So the last candle, I want you to see this. The last daily candle here just closed over 10K. So today on the daily chart, just for today, not for the week. We are now on the daily chart. Just for today, the 10K is like a support, because we are over it. The confirmation on the daily chart, not the weekly chart, on the daily chart is happening today. With the price staying over 10K, we get the confirmation, hey, 10K is now a good support for us. A good support for the next day or the next hours, not just like, man, okay, 10K is a good support, I get off for a week. That's not gonna work for us. That's not gonna work. So we need to keep in mind that every time frame here has another credibility. As we look at this peak here, it perfectly hits the second one, and it also hits like, yeah, the high from yesterday. So that's pretty much the top here, $10,500. So that's the range we are in today. Bad thing is that we have like here the spike. We couldn't go with enough buying pressure, and we are now going down again, testing 10K again. Every time you see a daily candle close like this, the higher the spike here is, the dot from the candle, the higher it is, then the higher is the possibility is that we can go down again a little bit, see a little bit of a step back. Every time you see this in the chart here, nice spikes to the top, nice spikes to the bottom, we see an uprise, nice spikes to the top, we see down, spikes to the bottom, we see an up, spikes to the top, we see a down. So that's something you keep in mind. You need to keep in mind that here is like the resistant area with today's top at $10,500. So let's make this up here pretty quick. So what can we also see? We see a nice uptrend here, of course. Let's just put it out here. I think everyone is seeing it, but let's just make an example. It's not so easy to pull here to find the right start for the trend, because you have so much high volatility here, but we all know that it starts down here and yeah, it's going up. Could also pick like this one here, that would be pretty nice. I think it grabs the most parts. Yeah. So for a line to be drawn, I take two things in mind. First thing is how long is this trend and how much points do I hit? So the longer the trend line is, the stronger it is. So the dark green one here is much stronger than this green tiny line we drawn just here. That's nothing. And the second part is not only how long it is, just how much point do it hit. We have here 1, 2, 3, 4 points. So that's good. That's why I draw the line from here right now. That's just my own experience and my own strategy. Of course, there are tons of it, and you can take every strategy, test it for yourself, and that's just build your own strategy out of other strategies, other experience. That's the best part about it, I think. Let's go into deep. Let's go deep here in 4 hours. For me, 4 hours deep, yeah. It's nice to look deeper, of course, if you want some action, but I wouldn't put too much money like a 15-minute chart. It's, that's pretty hard. So, because every line you draw, you get much tinier in the time frames, and the lines you're drawn are not so much, don't have as much credibility like a daily chart or a weekly chart, for an example. So you see like an uptrend and it's broken down, because on the higher time frames you're like in a correction right now, and so you need to see the bigger picture here. That's my opinion. So in the last 4 hours, here you see it's just one push. And we have now the step back here. The step back takes place to 10K right now. That's what we're gonna see here right now in this 4 hour candle, I think, in the next 40 minutes. And we will see the 10K again. Question is if it holds. If it not holds, it will fall down again to like an area around, I think, 9,700 maybe. Like this, the old resistance here. and it's now, because we are over this price level, it's now a support. So it could turn out that we are just falling down again to this area. Let's see, like falling down here, getting it again to 10, and that is the question, what's happened there. Either way, we push through it or we go again testing some deeper levels here. And nice thing is that we have the 50 and the 200 EMA on our side now. That was not the point here. Now they act like a support. You see it here, and you see it also on the way back up here. So the line will go like that here. It's more flexible than the 200. The 200 will just go, nah, I don't care. But the 50 will go up with us and will act like a support again here. And we can still make our way up here. Let's see if it makes sense what we have drawn here. So just a second. Here you go. You see, this line is not as long as the last one, and it only hits like 2 points, 3 points, if you point this one too. It has not as much credibility than the last one, and it can break much easier. So what we also see on the four hour chart is that we are here overbought, and that a correction is much more likely. A little setback. You have to keep in mind, the moment we shoot over 10k, there are be a lot of buying pressure. That's why that's happening here. They are pushing the price up, even if we are here in profit, and here starting the sellers because they see the resistance we just won. And yeah, all the guys who just was buying Bitcoin here over 10k, where's the stop loss? Tell me. Where should you put your stop loss on BitMEX if you are buying Bitcoin over 10k, like 10k100 with like an 10x? Where should you put your stop loss? It's like, yeah, maybe some dollars under 10k. That's where you put stop loss, because it's a really, really big meaning psychologically to the people. I hope I spell it right. Because 10k is like one more zero in the numbers, and yeah, it's a pretty big price, you know. And that's why they can easily drop the price down below to this level, to the support, to 9.7, and get it back up maybe, and take all the stops here, clean the market from this pump, and then pump. So that's something they had done in the past pretty often. So let's just make this here the one opportunity for the price to just go. And the important part here is that the second one, the second coming, if you want, so the second price up must be higher than the last one. It only continues with the trend if the next price level, the next high we build, is from the closed candles here on the 4-hour chart higher than the last one. So we must close over 10,200. That's where we need to build another base, as you want, to make higher highs, as you can see here. If you don't make higher highs like here, and you don't get to this level again, you drop down. Here you see you got the 50 line as resistance, so you drop down to the 200. But right now we have the 50 as support acting, and that's maybe the good thing. Let's see, we will find out here in a couple of hours. I want to ask you guys one thing. Please leave in the comment what type or what topic of video content do you want here on YouTube. What do you find interesting? What questions do you have about this market? I have a lot of topics to get, but I will also like to build something here with you guys. So if you have any suggestions, just ask me in the comments. I will answer you. And yeah, that's a possibility here, that you could go higher from here. So, let's see. So we, as we could get higher here, keep in mind that we are on the bigger picture in a big, big resistance area. That's a thing we must keep in mind for today. So for everyone out there, and I know everyone gets this comments in their videos, are just saying, yeah, it's in Germany we call this a Glaskugel. It's like a crystal ball, what you're telling us. I don't want to tell you a crystal ball. I just want to tell you that the outbreak we have right now is not confirmed only on the daily chart, not on the weekly, of course, because a new week just started. And you need to keep in mind for today that we can go under 10k again. It's most likely because they can make a lot of money with this trade. And for a big push up, for a pretty big push up here, we need to get over this resistance line. It's pretty important that, that you see this resistance area. I will go out here with you guys in the weekly chart again, and let's keep in mind this area right here. You can also follow me, of course, here on TradingView, because I think I will upload this chart here, of course, in TradingView too. And maybe it's possible I will upload it on YouTube too. If you have any questions about TradingView, just look up in the channel. Yesterday we got a video together where we created this account for free. So everything we do here, you can also get for free. So thank you very much for the watching. I would like, if you follow me, leave a like if you liked the content, if it helped you. And see you guys in the next video.